Now, we have this network we had considered in the last example, and we had worked this out for the over-allocation problem. We had the activities, you know, A to I here, and if you go back, if you recall, the critical path is here, A, B, C, F, G, I was the critical path. Activity D, E, and H had float. And we were going to try to use the floats of these activities. In the earlier exercises, we used the floats of these activities to resolve the over-allocation problem. In here, we are going to see again, here we go, activity D which has float. Okay, here we have activity D which has float, and then activity E has float and activity H has float. So we are going to try to move this. We could move this way, we could move it here, and as and when H moved, G could move to also move the resource profile. So based on these activities moving within the project duration using the float, the profile of the resources changed. And that is what we are again trying to do. So in this particular case, rather than resolving over-allocation, we are trying to try to level the resources, try to make the profile as flat as possible. So when we did this, what we had done in the earlier case was we moved from this scenario. We had the resources which were in excess of what we was available. We were able to level it to a scenario where we did not have any over allocation now. So this was moved, you know, as you can see, it has moved to where D moved. Now, we have, in some ways, you can say, yes, we have done some kind of leveling. We have allocated the resources in such a way there is no more over-allocation. But is this all is there to leveling is one of the questions. And obviously, the answer is no. You can see the resource profile here. There is variation in resource profile. How can I bring this to as leveled a profile as possible? Is that possible or not? So obviously, like when we talked about having a perfectly level profile, we have said that's ideal. But the question is, how do we level it to the maximum extent possible? So this is the basis on which we are going to kind of do some explorations. So if we had looked at different alternatives, so here you can see D is moving within its float. It's moved by 1 here. It's moved by 2 here. Okay, and here it's moved by 3. So each of these steps, as D moves, you can see the resource profile is changing. So here you have 10 and 14. Here you have 10 and 10. Okay, here B is moved down. You have 7 and 11. From it, what was 11 and 11 became 11 and 7. So as D moves, the profile changes. Okay, similarly, you will find I can move H to change the profile, I can move E to change the profile. So how do I keep changing the resource profile, and how much should I shift these activities to get the profile which I want? That is the kind of issue which we are going to explore. So if you look at from the float perspective, okay, D has 5 shifts it can do, H has 4 shifts, and he has 1 to 3 shifts, and it depends on how many shifts, because it's following H, I mean, because it's preceding H, it depends on how much H shifts for us to be able to shift E. So if we look at the profile here, or the number of options of shifting we can do, you will see there are several options. For example, I can keep H at the same place, E at the same place, and move D by five steps. Then I can move H by 1, E at the same place, move D again by 5 steps. So if I just keep E in the same place and I just move H and D, I have a total of 20 combinations of shifts I can do. Okay? So when we keep trying the various alternatives of what we can shift and what we can't shift, you'll find there are in the number of steps we can do, there are 50 alternatives. So this is somewhat about our solution space. It's about 50 possible options have to be explored to be able to see what our best resource profile we can get out of this is. And that is the flexibility we have with this current CPM or current network. The way the durations and the relationships have been given to us, that's the flexibility we have. We don't have any more alternatives. And you can see that as we have several activities which have float in a network, the alternatives will rapidly multiply. So even here, with 50 alternatives, it is possible to compute the resource profile for all 50 and then decide on which is the profile which I want.